Graham, what was your highlight of the night last night?
I would have to say Jimmy Allen doing the Charlie Pride tribute. I thought that was really, I don't know why it really hit me so much. I think because Charlie was actually there. I think sometimes with these tributes, like we saw with other ones, the Kenny Rogers, that it's after the person has passed away. So to give Charlie his flowers a little bit, I thought that was so powerful to see. And having Jimmy there, of course, because so much of 2020 has been talking about more diversity in country music. So I thought that was a really nice thing for them to do.
You know what I loved is you forget just how people can get nervous all over again, depending on the moment. I mean, Charlie has hosted the awards. He's been on that award show many times. And the fact that he was shaking and nervous in that moment, it was such an interesting and amazingly humanizing thing to see, don't you think?
Yeah, and I love when award shows do this too, like kind of taking the old and the new. Grammys do that all the time too, in terms of having these moments with a new artist that has been affected by that veteran artist. So it was great to see Jimmy and Charlie on that stage together.
It's funny because you never know what's going to hit home on nights like that. And so I'm watching and my wife kind of passively watches because I have to watch these things and she's a bit over it at this point. Award shows they're very long and we're trying to take care of a one-year-old in the background. And that was a moment where everything stopped in the room and everything was laser focused on what was happening. And she doesn't really know much about Charlie Pride or Jimmy Allen or what's going on there. And that moment just kind of floored her. And that just shows you the power those moments can have in a night like that.
Yeah. And I think because we're always focused on who's going to win this year, who won this award kind of thing. You're just so into the moment. And in a moment like that, you just realize the impact of someone's career over decades and really the power of music.
Mr. Chris Sheets, what was your highlight of the night last night?
Well, thanks for nothing, Graham, for stealing mine, of course, but that's all right. That's okay. You know, I'll say first of all, Charlie Pride, I mean, one of the very first concerts I ever went to as a young man was at a young boy, was like at 5 years old, went to a Charlie Pride concert at the Jubilee Auditorium in Edmonton. And I remember that show. I remember going back probably 10 years ago and seeing Charlie Pride and his son there. And so it was amazing that Charlie was there. You're 100% right to actually get the well-deserved credit he deserves with Jimmy Allen there. What a nice touch that was. But because it was 2020, I was waiting for like some kind of a dragon to break through the roof and pick up Charlie and take him away. You know, just because that would be our luck this year. But Charlie at 86 years old, you know, was nervous, obviously. I mean, he's aged, he's 86 years old, but picking up that well-deserved generational award was incredible.